Over the years, our family's had a share of health problems.
So prescriptions are a part of our life.
Before, we went to the big box store.
We both thought it would help us save. But with the long lines and impersonal service, filling prescriptions became a chore. That's when a friend recommended D&H.
Now Tristan knows our prescriptions. Brenda always helps us find the right vitamins. And after Dad's fall, Monica's been a real expert with all our home medical needs, all without the lines.
Trust and service.
That's our D&H.
Radio friends, this is Thursday, May the 30th, and we're so glad you're with us today. We've got two topics. We're going to talk, first of all, about a mammothon.
Correct.
Now, what is a mammothon? We'll find out right now. Okay. Kristen Fritchie, good to have you here, Kristen.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
Ellis Fischel Cancer Center, you're having a mammothon. I think I know what it is because we talked about it last year at this time.
Correct.
You try to do as many mammograms one day as possible.
Well, we're gonna separate it into 2 days.
2 days.
2 days, but we're offering it at times where people might not think that it would be as convenient. But you know, like if they're working or something like that, we want to be able to offer some different times.
Okay, why are you doing this?
Well, mammography is the number one way for early detection of breast cancer. So 1 in 8 women will develop breast cancer in their life.
1 in 8 women?
Correct. So if you're sitting at a table of 8 women, one of those women is most likely going to develop or has the chance of developing breast cancer.
And the early detection is made possible because of mammograms, correct?
Correct.
Even more so than the self-breast examination?
Yes, because you need to do that. You need to do self-breast exam once a month. You need to have your clinical exam once a year. But you also need mammography because it may not, or it should detect something that maybe you may not be able to feel on the upper level.
So mammothon.
Correct.
Running 2 days. When does it start?
It's going to be June 7th.
Is it running all day or is
It's going to be that night. So 6 p.m. to 12 midnight.
6 p.m. to 12 midnight?
Correct. Correct.
So it's kind of like a big party that you're having.
Well, in a way. I mean, we're going to have education and resources, refreshments, door prizes.
And where are you doing this?
At Ellis Fischel Cancer Center, our new patient care tower, which is over here on One Hospital Drive now.
So from 6 o'clock until midnight.
Correct.
First night.
Yes, on Friday, June 7th. And then Saturday, June 8th is 7 a.m. to noon.
Okay. Well, so you're not taking much of a break there. Midnight, then you start back at 7 o'clock in the morning.
Correct.
How long should each lady plan on spending there?
15, 20 minutes.
That's it?
Yes. Yes.
So it's kind of bang, you're in, you're out.
Yeah, or they can spend as much time there as they would like with the education aspect of it or the resources.
Okay, what about the cost?
The cost will go through their insurance. However, if they do not have insurance, we do have different grants and different ways to help offset that cost.
So what you're saying then, if I'm reading this right, is nobody's going to be turned away.
Correct. But they do need an appointment.
Okay. But nobody's going to be turned away. But you should make an appointment. So you're not doing any walk-ins at all.
We could potentially do a walk-in. In our last year's mammothon, we did have 3 walk-ins. But we would prefer to have the appointment based on the fact that we could either check with their insurance first or do the grant paperwork first.
All right. So how do they make the appointment?
It would be by calling our phone number, which is 573-882-8511.
Okay, 573-882-8511.
Correct.
For the mammothon, which is running June
7th and 8th.
June 7th and 8th, 6 o'clock till midnight on Friday and 7 o'clock till noon on Sunday.
On Saturday.
Saturday.
Yes.
On Saturday.
Yes.
Okay, all right. And thank you so much.
Thank you very much for having me.
I hope you will. You'll fill up every slot.
I hope so. We have almost 100 slots to fill, so anybody can call.
Okay. Thank you
very
much.
Great.
Good to have you. Good to have you here. And I hope that at midnight you still got people standing in line waiting to do
it. Well, so do we.
You won't turn them away.
No, sir. Oh,
okay.
All right. Thank you.
Kristen, thank you so much. Now I turn to Karen Grundy and see Missouri Contemporary Ballet. And you were here not that long ago, but you were here talking about Kickstart.
Yes.
And this was a fundraiser for you to go, Missouri Contemporary Ballet, to go to
South Korea.
And how did that fundraiser do?
We did it. We went over our goal.
Okay.
So we're on our way.
So now your group is going to South Korea when?
We leave July 3rd.
And the whole purpose of that was?
We are the guest. We were invited by Sunshin Bay, which is a sister city of Columbia.
Mm-hmm. We've got a bunch of sister cities,
yeah,
don't we?
Yeah, there are. So they have a big international exposition, and we'll be performing there. We have three performances while we're there.
Okay, so when you come back from South Korea, will you come on here and tell us about
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely.
But that's not what you're here to talk about today. No. Today you're here to talk about Alice's Adventures in Wonderland.
Yes.
What is this?
This is an original production by Missouri Contemporary Ballet and myself, all original music by Tom Andes. We've been working on this production for probably over a year. Tom's been working on the music
really?
For 9 months.
This is all original?
All original.
That's fantastic.
Yep.
And so why, besides the fact that it's all original and it's all local, why should people want to come to see
this? Well, it's a professional production. It's at Jesse Auditorium. It's Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. So it is based off of C.S. Lewis's book. Mm-hmm. We have 40 students from throughout Columbia and other areas around Columbia. It's live music, and it's going to be an amazing show. We have all of the characters.
All of the Alice in Wonderland characters.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And this is something that took 9 months to write.
Pretty much. I mean, we've been talking about it for over a year, to get the whole thing come together. It's the first time Missouri Contemporary Ballet has done a full-length ballet.
Is it difficult to interpret the movements that you're going to do to the original music that Tom Andes wrote?
No, Tom and I work together a lot. Like, what's the feel for this scene, and what are you thinking? And so we've been working together for years, and just this whole process has been amazing to do.
Yeah.
There's been little time when I'm like, okay, we gotta take that out. Or.
But there's 40 performers.
There's 40 students, and then my 9 professional dancers. So and then we have a couple cameo appearances.
So over 50 performers, mm-hmm. not counting the musicians.
Correct.
And how many musicians are
there? We have 9 musicians, so almost 60 people.
Yeah. Well, you could end up filling up the Missouri Theater with their friends and relatives.
Well, let's hope so. It's actually at Jesse Auditorium.
Oh, Jesse Auditorium.
Yeah,
we
have to make sure we tell people
okay.
that.
Okay, Jesse Auditorium.
We're usually at Missouri Theater, but it's at Jesse.
So this one will be at Jesse Auditorium Saturday. Oh, the same day of the Mammothon.
A weekend before.
Oh, that's right, the weekend before. There's the next weekend. So you can come to this and go to the Mammothon.
Yep.
Saturday, June the 1st, 7 o'clock. And Sunday, June the 2nd, you have a 2 o'clock matinee. And this will be at Jesse Auditorium, not the Missouri Theater this
Correct.
Time. And for ticket information, what do they do?
ConcertSeries.org. They can also go to our website, MissouriContemporaryBallet.com.
Okay, you got it. Thank you. And have a good trip to South Korea.
Thank you very much.
All right, we'll see you when you come back.
Thanks.
Tomorrow, we're talking about Art in the Park that's coming up this weekend. Our program with Diana Moxon. Our program directed by Travis McMillan of the Reynolds Journalism Institute. Audio is Pat Akers from KBIA. Our floor director is Rich Polzine, and our assistant producer and guest coordinator, Uncle James Mauser. And if you'd like to watch this program or listen to it again and sign up for a free podcast or vodcast, kbia.org.